So for our next presenter, she obtained her Bachelor of Science in Education from the West Visayas State University in 1990 and her Master of Arts in Art History degree from the University of the Philippines, Diliman. With her thesis on Spanish colonial cemeteries of Iloilo, she found herself in built cultural heritage work. Eventually, she gravitated towards researching and promoting local food and culture. She started a food blog in 2007 and shifted to posting photos with short food posts in her Facebook and also Instagram. With a Chad grant in 2019, her team produced Batid, a video documentary on three outstanding Ilonga food artisans. She was also inspired to write about a heritage karinderia in Tiolas and an extraordinary Suman Latik maker from the La Paz for the Doreen Fernandez food writing competition. She takes great pride in her students' outputs in Karankon or Karanunan Congress, where they showcase little-known Ilonggo food artisans in an exhibition. An offshoot of this was a creative food mapping workshop for Balasan, Iloilo, then Ibahay, Aklan. Let us give a round of applause for Ms. Marie Joy Sumagaysay.
All right, so this is slightly different from sayang, wala na yung mga estudyante. Because I tweaked my presentation for them. Okay, I have a video for you. Okay. Ah, yeah, later. You have a pointer. Okay, what is this? This is a video. Okay, sir. Wala. Never mind. Please play lang kahit walang audio. I'll just run you through it. This is a project I did for my students during pandemic. So, sige lang, ma'am. Sir, play mo lang. So, in-interview yung nanay niya.
Ina, ni Richard Farrares. Ngayon,
ninenervyos ang nanay.
Then ay linupak in Tagalog. Sa aming dialect, ito ay tinatawag na busat. Ito ang natutunan ko sa aking nanay nung high school pa ako.
Ang mga sangkap o ingredients ay ang sumusunod. Number one, saging. Number two, niyog. At saka number three, asukan. Unang-una, ang saging ay lulutuin. Habang ito ay niluluto, ang niyog naman ay babalatan.
Tingnan niyo yung estudyante. No experience. Pero matatalino yung mga yan. Hindi talaga kaya. Tumulong ang tatay. Hindi matiis. I want you to look at the expression of that teenager.
Asukang bunot kay.
Oh, okay. Thank you, sir. Okay. Yan ang Gen Z-er. Ito yung problem na ni-raise kahapon, di ba? Like, anong gagawin natin with them? Kasi these are so techie people. They are so creative. Next slide, please. Okay. Pero to answer, yung mga weaknesses nila can be turned into strengths or their strengths can be used for them to love heritage. Like this. This was last semester. I challenged them to tweak without changing the food. So they bought good quality ibos, but look at what they did. They turned it ibos with three dips. So merong appealing, diba? There's cheese, there's condensed milk or tawagin na lang caramel. Kasi the Gen Zers love labels na ganling. Tapos, they have tableya dip. And then the other one, that's bye-bye mochi. I hindi ko talaga yan maisip. Only the young can do that. So, which leads me to my talk today. I'm sharing with you creative approaches I've done through the years for heritage appreciation. And we'll just run through them through pictures because the focus for today's presentation is a serious OBE material that I made with the help of a mentor. Okay. Yan. Oh, sandali po, sir. Saan kayo? Okay lang. Sige. San tayo? Just look for yourself there. You are? Look at the time you're born from 1997 to 2012. Then you're a Gen Z. Gen Z because the Z is for? Why Gen Z? Zoomers. Gen Z is Zoomers. Kami, ma'am, tayo ay Gen X. Okay. There, anong characteristics ng millennials and Gen Zs? They love coffee. They love being in coffee shops. And they like Western stuff. Western and also Asian. Like Korean, Japanese. Tapos, maporma talaga. No? Tapos, that girl did digital art. She did that. Grabe talaga. I mean, everybody. Not just a few. Lahat talaga. No? You agree? Okay, so this is my belief that with well-thought-out creative learning experiences facilitated by dedicated mentors like us, then the Gen Zers and the millennials can become the best ambassadors for heritage. That's my belief. Okay? Yeah. So I did a cookshop in my home, classmate ng anak ko, and ayan, may pa-decorate ng suman. So, okay. Tawag namin suman. Sa Tagalog, biko. Okay. So ito po, these are the things I've done. I've done those things, written outputs, cookshop strategies na ginawa ko, activities, infographs, etc. No? Pero, ang requirement nito talaga is yun. The requirement is we need to have teachers, mentors, who are, number one, passionate. Okay, lalabas yun eh. Kasi kung hindi naman niya love yung ginagawa niya, so the kids will see. And number two, ayan, cares for the Gen Z. And number three, ito po. Kasi I realized there are many teachers in high school and college also. Magpapagawa lang ng video. Okay, video. Do a video. No supervision. No guidance. No feedback. Tapos gagridan na lang. So, that's not effective at all. So, we as mentors, teachers, we really have to do this. Constant yan. Tapos, their first draft, whether it's written, a vlog, or a video, we have to give feedback and tell them, okay, please redo that. Importante talaga yun. Okay? So, let's have some photos of these things that I've done. There. What is that? Infographs. Okay? Yan. That one, tinuom, kasi the student, she's now a doctor. She's very good pala sa art. Tapos, the data that she gathered about tinuom, okay na rin, pero parang 70% accurate lang. So, I helped, fixed it. So, it's a collab work. So, yan yung labas. If you want to know how to cook tinuom the Ilonggo way, I'll share with you that infograph. You can do it. And then here, this is also, it looks like a cute poster. Pero sa totoo lang, that's very academic. Because it's my exam for this class. At yung exam na yon is very detalyado. Like you have to put in 200 words. Like I had a series of questions and you have to put that together and answer it through, you know, you see that paragraph there. So hindi yan cut and paste from Wikipedia. It's really the answer to the question. But, dulce,
But it's turned into a creative output for them. Okay, another one is this. So, art support for artisans. I made them do labels that the food artisans used. So, free lang yan, no? So, project nila, tapos binigay sa artisan. Eh, this one. This is the memorable for many of my students. Yan. We had a fashion show. No handlers. No handlers. Kasi sa DepEd, sorry ha, pero I noticed, ganun ang nangyayari sa mga eco-eco fashion. They would get outsiders to do the costume and all of that. But this one, the students did that. So, abstraction. So, I think this one is Pancit Molo. The other one is Bat Choy. Yung outfit na yun. Okay. And then, of course, food walks. Yeah. We went to the Central Market and we did a Bat Choy taste test. So, we ordered from 3 different Bat Choyan. Tapos blind taste test. So the owners of the Bat Choyan were looking kung sino ang pinili. Of course, we did not announce it there. We went out of the ano. Yeah, kasi sakit yun sa loob na hindi napili. Okay. Ngayon, ayan, this is has been going on for nakailan na kami. I think we're on our 8th. We call it Karancon. You know, the students did that. I just provide the information. Tapos I tell them, we just make sure there's a patajong ha in your poster. But the design, it's up to you. So you see, what I'm trying to say is, we just have to tap their potential and guide them. This is what happens during Karancon. Karanunon Congress. So it's a project, it's a research project, and the output is a poster. With the information about the artisan, history and all of that. And of course, I edit that. So, hindi pwedeng that comes out na hindi i-edit ng ano. Kasi nakakahiya, di ba? So, yan. And then, they display the food of that artisan. Tapos, it's open to anyone who wants to eat. Yes. Okay. And then, I have 5 minutes. Okay, you see the red. Now, here today, I'm presenting a formalized OBE learning module. I asked help from an expert in OBE, Dr. Al Bautista, and this is the outcome. Look. Yan. So, I'll give you time to look at it. My lesson, which is for 3 hours, is composed of 5 portions. So you start with, that's the subtopic, no? Our lesson topic. Of course, that will correspond to what you're expecting the students to achieve, learning outcomes. So in this 3-hour session, number 1, they should be able to identify ano yung mga rice cakes. Number 2, explain the function of rice cakes. Number 3, Asian rice cakes. 4, participate in the cookshop. So the cookshop is inside the lesson. The 3 hours is not just devoted to cooking, but it's only part of the whole lesson. And number 5, express insights and reflections. So what is the activity for that? What is the output for number 5? Gen Zers, what are you expected to make? An essay. Go to the outputs assessments. You're expected to make an essay, but not a boring essay on bond paper, but in FB. You're reading it? Yeah, so a reflection essay with the photo you took, not the photo from online, reflecting new knowledge, application, personal meaning. So aside from this horizontal syllabus, I have a detailed teacher's guide, which I'm sharing with all the teachers here. It's open source. I'm making it open source. Ask it from me. You can apply this to your own place also. Okay? There you go. So that's how detailed it is. It looks detailed, but it makes it clear na ano bang expected mo na output from the students. Tapos may rubric pa. So the students know. Okay, So this is the teacher's guide. I'll share that with you also. That's so detailed. So this is talking to the teacher what to do. Next. Another one. Okay, don't forget these three. If you want to go into serious food research, you've got to read their books. FP Santa Maria, follow her online. She has Instagram, and all her researches are written there. She has a huge collection of old dictionaries. Okay, there you go again. You want to try? Let's try. Okay, infograph making contest, 1 minute. Can you get the paper, please? Miss Anne will help me. Let's do it for the students, okay? Okay, ready? What are you going to do? In 1 minute, I want you to make an infograph of Cebuano Karanunon or Kakanin. Cebuano. Infograph, you know. So you just draw it, right? And put the name. 1 minute, sir. Ready? Infograph of Cebuano Kakanin or Karanunon. 3, 2, 1, start. You put it sa, ano, matigas. Anong time na? Okay. 50 seconds left. Draw. You're going to draw the kakanin. Don't coach mama. No, on one paper, all of it should be there. That's an infograph. Yeah, but you're doing it individually. So you have to put as many as you can, not just one. That's an infograph. Sige, ma'am, go. Kasali ka. Kailangan more than one. Mapapahiya tayo kay mamaan, hindi kayo nakinig sa kanyang presentation yan. Okay, time? Oh, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. You have to put the name. 4, 3, 2, 1. Ma'am Anne, can you collect it, please? Finish or not, collect it. And then you decide sinong pinakamarami will give a prize. I have a prize. Okay. So that's what I'll do for the students. That's only part one. So there are other parts, right? No more time, but we can do this also, sana, but here. Okay, functions of rice cakes in the Philippines. So you can draw it out from the students. This is Asia. Can you identify them? This is Asia. No, there's no palitaw outside the Philippines. So the one on the left is Onde Onde. It's from Indonesia. It sounds like Inday-Inday, diba? So, hindi siya feminine. It's Onde-Onde. That one is Kue Kochi. That's Bukayo. Similar to ours. And that one is Japanese Mochi. This one is Malaysia. This is Putu Piring. In Bicol, they have something like this, Puto Sabao. And this one is the Indian Kerala Putu. Putu. And this one is Putumayam. So Cebu has Putumaya, but this is Putumayam from Malaysia, India, Kerala. Which one? That's curry. So what I want to show here to the class when we get to this part is that it's a shared Asian heritage. Okay? So that's it. And then the cookshop. So I tried this approach for Gamot Kogon Waldorf, a Waldorf school. So it was fun. They made their own fire, everything from scratch. And that one is Philippine Science High School. So we did palitaw cookshop. Dito sana, but mahirap eh. So that's it. There you go. So kayang-kaya. Okay, salamat. Thank you, miss.
Thank you very much, Ms. Marie Joy Sumagaysay. And before we proceed, we would like to thank Dr. Erlinda Alburo, former Cebu City Center Director, for coming to our conference. Daghang salamat, Doc.